little change of plans here. I was thinking of mounting this piece first and boring it, but it turned out there's maybe 1 millimeter too much swing, so I have to remove the gap on the lathe to be able to swing this. So I do this piece and another one first, and then finally remove the gap and do this one to save some time, because time is of the essence on this project. So now I'm trying to get loose these bolts that the galvanizing firm put in to protect the threads, but they're really in there. So that's as close as I have to get it. We have to take about 2 millimeter off here, and it's hard to indicate when it has been welded here, it has distorted, and also the galv zinc coating. So I always keep a crappy old indicator for this type of work when it's rough. Yeah, we had to put our tools down for a minute and go and get some coffee. It's getting cold now. The autumn is here, I guess. It's only, what is it, 5 degrees Celsius. And actually I had to scrape the windshield this morning. So that's the sign. Warm days are over. I just finished this diameter and this axial load surface, and now we got the pitch that we like for Delrin bushing. This is actually not nylon, it's white Delrin. So it's 0.2 millimeter in play. And it actually feels a lot less when this big diameter and this long bearing surface. So you have to take in account that plastic always deforms when it's put out in the weather and so forth. Delrin is actually one of the most stable plastics when humidity and other things come into play. Using nylon outside I wouldn't recommend, because it's actually very, very sensitive for moisture, and it will expand, and maybe you will end up with a crane that doesn't rotate. So Delrin is a good choice for outside, but don't go too tight on this type of work where it's not critical. So point two, I feel confident that that will be enough for this crane to live a long happy life. Now I'm taking the finishing cut on the lower housing. After this we will machine face cut this flange, and then we will try to press one of the Delrin bushings in. Hopefully it will go smoothly. So we're fighting with the Harmonix. This is only a 32mm inner cutting boom. But I have bigger ones, but they are all insert and all negative cutting angles, so they're not cutting as freely, and I get pretty much Harmonix with them, with this far stick out. So this old welded boom seems to work a little better, cuts a little more freely with a neutral cutting angle. So now we got the last housing left to do, so now it's time to remove the gap. It's actually a tapered pin. So it's not when tightening you're loosening the pin. So let's try that on this one. This is a setup that I call creepy. There's a weld bead here, so I haven't got much purchase in the truck. And also this thing flying around. So just for safety, I have put through here, all the way up here, a drawbar, and tighten it so it won't come loose from the truck. So one thing to think about when you're putting drawbars through the spinner, that you don't want to over tighten it, because you can actually bend the spindle itself. So, but this is a pretty big spindle, so it can handle it. But on smaller lathes, it's very easy to bend the spindle itself. Just a hundred of a millimeter can cause some damage to the bearing. So that's a thing to think about. So we seem to handle the unbalance pretty good here. See, we can't drive it too much. 200 revolutions seems to be okay. So I think we can manage to complete this part without putting any balance weights on the piece itself. We will see. So the final housing is done, and now it's time to press the bushing in. So let's see how it turns out. Almost airtight. This is I just wanted a very light press fit, so I don't want to compress the bushing too much, or I will lose clearance on the shafts. Yeah, that turned out perfect. Now it's only I got to put some grease fittings on this housing and on the bottom housing as well. And then it's just a locking pin for locking the rotation, and this will be done. So it looks like I made the deadline this time. Oh, it's gonna be mounted. Now it's Tuesday. It's gonna be mounted on Thursday and Friday. So I had to burn the midnight oil on this one to make sure I made it in time. So, but that's how it is sometimes. Thank you. So what I like to use when I'm deburring plastics is just a old file, three-sided 60-degree file, and it's you shouldn't sharpen it too much or it will dig in. You might have experience trying to do the burning plastic and it just digs in. So, but this works very nice for me. I know there's a special ceramic, I'm sure, yes, Tom Lipton showed one on a video. I never tried those, but I never had problem with this type either, so yeah, don't make them too sharp. So, everything mounted all right, everything fit. So, this piece goes to the ground, and on top of this, the crane pole itself will mount. So down here we have the bushing. And this is not the self-lubricant D-ring. This is the one you have to lubricate. So you always have to check what you order. So there's many types of D-ring. And there on the crane it's a similar plate to this one. This is feather and that's through. So it will bolt down. And here it's a similar hole on the other plate that goes on top of this one. So you will be able to stick a rod down and lock the crane. I'm gonna make it protrude here and a hole, and you can put a lock so the kids won't play with the crane at night. So that's that. And here's the top of the crane. This will go into the pole, and here's the D-ring bushing. It goes nicely, and there will be beams going backwards like this down to the ground. So this rotating unit is up about 9 meters, I think, and from here it will protrude at a 30-degree angle, about 5 meters more, I think. But it will be grease fittings on this as well, because there's a ladder going up to this level, but not all the way out on the boom. So they will be able to grease this one also. Now I'm making the locking pin for a rotating assembly, and I like to use my small Taiwanese lathe. It's very good precision. Taiwan makes good lathes, I think. A little thing when you're using a lathe this small is that you shouldn't use inserts. You should use high-speed steel and learn how to grind and hone your own high-speed steel, because you will get super nice finish and no problems, because these lathes aren't tough enough to handle the insert with negative cutting angles and things like that. So a nice sharp high speed is highly recommended for a lathe this size.